So hi everyone, we're here with Mr. Zhang, who is one of the artists of Malden Window Arts. And behind us we can see his awesome work, and we're here to talk to him about his work. 所以我们今天非常荣幸能够跟张先生在这边对话关于你的作品。那首先请你给我们做一个自我介绍吧。
好的，我这个画是从小喜欢，我小时候在马路上画画，那时候没有笔，没有纸，在马路上画。读书了以后呢，一直在画。我画画就是画了50年。小时候画，大了画，工作也是画画。我在广州大学服装学院教美术，我还在广州美院当过老师，我还在大凡村油画，大凡油画从北京这个有个宋庄。艺术家们集资的地方，全国跑的是画画，就是。
So he said that he has been painting for so many years since he was a little boy. And back then when he was a little boy, he used to paint in the street because he didn't have paper or pencil even. So he would actually do it in the street. And since then he has been painting all these years, and he was in China. I think he said he was teaching at a fashion school in Guangzhou, and he has had so many other roles like teaching and also some activities with artists later. So anyway, so that's really amazing. 那你能告诉一下我们你的一些作品他们的灵感是怎么来的，而且他们关于他背后的故事。
好，这些画就是我用西洋的画法油画啊，英语就 oil paint， 但是我画面的元素呢，很多成分啊，很多元素就是中国元素，好像这服装啊后面的背景啊，都是中西结合在一起画，虽然是油画，但是是中国人的油画。不是美国人或者英国人、西方人的油画。
So we see here these two paintings. They are oil painting, which is a Western style of painting. But he said his specialty is to incorporate Chinese elements to these oil paintings. So you can see the subject is about a Chinese lady, and her dress is all traditional Chinese clothing, and also the background in the painting is also very Chinese. So he really enjoys incorporating Chinese elements to oil painting, which is known as a Western style painting. So that's really special.
谢谢，非常漂亮。那你一般绘画的灵感是从哪里来呢？
我这个画画呢，就是一个是平常观察啊，我喜欢画画，特别喜欢画人物画，对一些人物特感兴趣，好像我坐车都是要看人的表情啊，人的交流，互相之间的感受，所以都是生活上一个积累，不是你突然想到怎么画就怎么画。
So ask him, tell us where is your inspirations are coming from. So he said he especially likes to paint people, and because of that he would pay close attention to people in the street in daily lives. So if he takes a bus, he'll look at everyone on the bus to get inspiration for his painting. So it is coming from real life, and he just transferred them into his art. So we see some of these like amazing sketches here. Let's ask him about these.
那我们看到这边的素描作品，素描也非常多，就人物画的素描。那你能告诉我一下，这些素描作品的背景吗？
我是每天都在画素描，绘画的基础在于素描。你不论学中国画、西油画、西方画，都是素描是基础。所以我每天画素描，以前还画速写，一天一个本子几十张。我现在每天在哈佛广场就画这些人物，十几分钟画一张，有时候画十几张，有时候画几张。没人来的时候，我自己在画，在练。所以是素描是基础。
So he does sketches every single day. He believes that sketches is the very basic techniques for any type of art form. So he uses this way of drawing sketches to practice his skills. And he does it every day, and he draws people walking by in the street or anyone that he sees around him to do the sketches. And he said he actually goes to Harvard Square and draw people right there. So he said he would do like over 50 sketches a day. And they take, these ones take just like a little bit over 10 minutes. So these
十几分钟就可以画出来。是是是，十几分钟。啊，他们都是真实的人物，对吧？当然，都是对着张元画的。
Yeah, so these took like less than 20 minutes, and they are real people that he meet in his daily life. So that's really, really cool. 画得非常快，也非常好。谢谢，谢谢。 Yeah, so he's showing us of some of the pictures of his sketches and the real person. So he does this in Harvard Square, and seems like that he has thousands of these in the iPad. So can you show us more? So these all take less than 20 minutes. Amazing. Oh, actually I recognize this guy. So this is Lang Lang, who is a very famous Chinese, very young pianist. So Mr. John told me that he took a picture of him off the internet and did a painting based on the picture, but it looks like so real. I mean, obviously very real, otherwise I won't be able to recognize him. So, all right, so we also see that you have a painting here of a scenery.
这边有一张风景的话，那能告诉我们一下你画风景？我风景也喜欢画，但是比人物画的少，偶尔也画几张。就是每来到美国画像美国风景，以前在中国就画一些名山大川，主要是画中国画风景多，油画画风景画的比较少，主要是画人物。
So he likes drawing people the most, but sometimes he'll still draw a beautiful scenery that he come across. And in China, he'll go to the mountains, the nature, to draw pictures of them. But mostly he does painting of people. Nice. So so we heard that you had a very, very large painting. Done.
就是你最大的那幅画告诉我们是怎么一个？那是苏里兰卡馆，我帮苏里兰卡馆画的都是苏里兰卡本地的风情、佛像啊，一些特定的图案啊，几百张拼起来一幅画，主要是佛教方面的。苏里兰卡一个佛教国家，所以它的那幅画就代表了苏里兰卡的文化，就是苏里兰卡的文化的综合体现。
那个是世博会的那个展览的那幅画吗？它有多大呢？它有大概有300平米吧，几百张拼起来，我也记不住了，就是几百张，400多张，每张差不多一平米啊，我大约算一下300平米。So he has done a very, very large painting, which is 300 square meters, which was for the Shanghai Expo. Yeah, Shanghai Expo in 2010, and that painting was about Buddhism. So so obviously he does a lot of painting about culture as well. So 非常感谢张先生今天接受我们的采访，然后你的话非常非常的用英文讲叫 amazing，
就是，I don't know amazing， 现在懂了 amazing。
So he actually learned the English word amazing. I bet he come across that all the time. People say, oh, it's amazing all the time. So he actually learned that English word. So thank you so much. 谢谢。谢谢。谢谢。
Why does everybody wanna mess with?